morning, children. Welcome to the another class of English literature. Chapter 12, Champa's Fruit Basket. Do you remember, children, what we have done in our previous class? Yes, we have started with this chapter, Champa's Fruit Basket. And let's do a quick recap. There was a little girl named Champa. She had a garden with many fruit trees in it. And she wanted to go to her friend's house. And what was her friend's name, children? Punni. So she asked her mother and said, "I am taking some fruits for Punni as she likes fruits to eat." Her mother said okay and told her to come home soon. So Champa took 3 bananas and 2 guavas in her basket and started her journey towards Punni's house. A monkey was sitting on a branch of tree. It looked at the basket. It bent from the tree and took the bananas away. As monkey likes bananas, he wanted to eat them and he took the bananas from the fruit basket of Champa. And Champa did not notice as she was busy walking towards Punni's house. Now let's see, children, what happens in part 2. Chapter 12, Champa's Fruit Basket, Part 2. Children, we have seen that Champa puts 3 bananas and 2 mangoes in a basket to give her friend Punni. And she starts walking towards Punni's house. On the way, Champa passes a small tree and a monkey takes the bananas, and Champa did not notice that and she keep walking towards her friend's house. Now let's see, children, what happened next. On the way, there were 2 parrots nearby. They looked at the basket. So children, as you can see in the picture, after monkey, when Champa moved further, there were 2 parrots nearby flying and they looked at the basket. And they saw guavas. We like guavas. So children, we all know that parrots like guavas. And the 2 parrots also get interested in the 2 guavas which were kept in Champa's fruit basket. And they flew down and took the guava and flew away. So children, as you can see in the picture, the 2 parrots took the guava and they flew away. Champa did not see the parrots. Once again, children, Champa was so busy in moving that she doesn't notice the 2 parrots taking the guavas with them. And she starts moving further. Next, children, a cow looked at Champa. It saw the big basket in Champa's hand. So children, you can see in the picture that a cow looked at Champa and it saw a big basket in Champa's hand. The cow was frightened. So when he saw a big basket in Champa's hand, maybe he thought that Champa wants to hit him. And the cow was frightened. And he says, "Moo," said the cow. It jumped and bumped into an orange tree. So children, where the cow was standing, there was an orange tree. And when the cow was frightened, he jumped and bumped into an orange tree. Then what happened, children? Some oranges fell into Champa's basket. So what happened, children? When the cow bumped into the orange tree, some oranges fell into Champa's basket. And as usual, children, once again, Champa did not notice that oranges were kept in the fruit basket. And she starts moving further. Soon, Champa reached Punni's house. "Hello, Punni," said Champa. So children, when we all meet our friend, what we say? Hello to them. So like that, Champa also said hello to Punni. "Here is some fruit for you." So when Champa met Punni, she offered her some fruits. And what Punni said? "Thank you. I like oranges." So when Punni saw some oranges in the basket, she told that, "Thank you, I like oranges." And Champa was shocked. She told, "Oranges?" And she started thinking how oranges were exchanged with bananas and guavas. Because we know, children, that in the beginning, Champa put two guavas and two bananas in the fruit basket. Where did the bananas and guavas go? She starts thinking. So children, this was our chapter 12, Champa's fruit basket. Hope you all enjoyed the story and you all have understood it. Please see the video once more. Thank you.